Now, the feeling outside of the derby, what I am aware of, of course, is to clean that horrible 6-1 away from last week. It was a defeat never to forget. It hurt inside the club, players, the whole club. It hurt very hard. Also, when you see 6-1, it's not a mirror how hard the boys worked from the first day. So it was not a mirror how we worked from the first day. Unfortunately, 5 players came very late in. So it is always a kind of circumstances. And I've tried to build up everything together, because when it goes back, the coach must be the most positive person. And we were from the first day. Tomorrow we have to react. And derby or no derby, we have to clean out the 6-1.
Thank you, coach.
What can you tell us about the team of Varaždin? Your opponent.
Now, outside of the derby, we saw it last week against Gorica. Gorica could score a lot of goals, I believe the first half, and Varaždin almost scored a 2-1 on the end, in the 90th minute. So it's a very good organized team, with a good striker, we all saw that, good left winger, and the rest. All specific qualities, we've tried to analyze them today, as you could see there. But I think we are the own opponent tomorrow. How we react in our head after the 6-1. Everybody is aware of the derby atmosphere. And that they are a dangerous team. A good team, a well-organized team, we all know.
Are you going to change something maybe?
Yeah, I have to.
Yes?
Yeah.
Some players maybe?
Yeah, we change, yeah. Look, last week was already what I told you before the game. We have players late in. We had to play with them. But for example, Abekpoorn went out last week was a big loss. It's also logical because he only trained 4 days. So also today is a question mark. Can he play, yes or no? Mario Marina will be back. So depending on if Abekpoorn and Marina is back, yeah, that gives you a lot of defensive stability on the midfield. Where was our problem last week?
Međimurec, what is his condition? Međimurec.
From Vingo. Yeah, as I said, normally you train 6 weeks with the same group. So normally the preparation is 6 weeks, double possessed, the same group. Yeah, he came very late. We were stable against Rijeka, otherwise the youth had played, Glevnok and Eskinja, that game. But yeah, that was a test for us that we had to fall back on the experience. And Rakic and Vingo were not game ready normally because they have no rhythm. But that he is a stable factor is a fact. Now he will start, he has a week more training. Rakic has a week more training, Marina is back, so I think we better possessed.
What is the condition of
Kamaikov? Very bad. Look, after the 3-1, as we all know, I changed one striker out for Kamaikov because I heard in the past he was here one of the best players. But it's also a fact he had only 3 days training. So he already had to compensate in the game and now he's injured. So he makes now an ultrasound for his muscles. Because, yeah, he has totally no preparation. So he needs time.
You had many young players during the preparation period, but they didn't play in Osijek. What's the reason? Are they not ready for
the reason was or? The reason was the test against Rijeka. There we played with Majerić on the midfield, Eskinja, Glevnak, Krušek. We had Carlo came in. Marco Boros. He played on a very vital position before the defense on Saktas. So Marco played because he was the most consistent player in the preparation, but the rest was not ready. That's the answer. They are still not ready, but we believe in them.
Can you tell us when will your team be ready? In what amount of time?
The new players who come need 4 weeks because they came on only a short time ago. So that's why we also will adapt a little bit our pressing style. As you have seen the first half, first 30 minutes, we pressed very high, but we did the whole preparation. had advantages, had disadvantages. I still think we didn't stand behind the tree, we didn't shoot balls away and had a destructive style. That's the glass half full. I compliment him with him. But the mistakes we made defensively, third minute, second goal, yeah, it is disgusting. It was disgusting. We came back to 2-1. And even then we were in the game. And the 3-1 killed us. The header of, do I say it right? Fucsak. Now, and then I changed second half Kamaikov to give him rhythm. So the 6-1 was a little bit against what we deserved. It could also be 10-1, to be honest. We must be realistic and back in that. So we need time to play our pressing style. So we will adapt a little bit our pressings modus. So we will not press like we did there.
Can you tell us, do you need more players?
Yeah.
How many?
How many is depending on the budget. Look, we are a small club. And that's why the 6-1 hurts so much. We are fighting club. We are underdog club. We have the less budget. That's why it still, I say it again, it hurts so much also to the fans. Because we are not in a position that we can say, oh, I want that and that and that position. At the moment, in fact, we are on our max. And that's also what you say, a chance for the youth. Should be a chance, but in Rijeka, yeah, that was the last test. You ready or not ready? So we are still looking, but it's not easy.